feels on an iceberg here in Juneau. We're coming into Juneau. There, yeah. Let's zoom in on it.
I can't tell if it's
I'm gonna try to hold it still.
Oh, that's cool.
No, there's the seal.
Still.
You wanna
see?
Pretty.
Is it on the thing?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right up there.
There's some
seals.
On this little piece of ice. The long piece of ice.
Quite a bit.
Yeah.
Here's what we're looking at about 6:30 this morning. Alaska being this blue. When it's zoomed out, it's semi blurry.
Glaciers originated in France, and so we have these wonderful, wonderful words associated with them. Arete, Cirque, Minnetonka, Serac, Quebec.
Wait, put a large face. It's 200 feet tall. But I want to have attention to the little here off to the port side now, which is called Fjord Terror. As we talk about dynamics, we also need to talk about tide. I said that the tides that roll around Alaska are the second highest in the world. So we'd be talking about displacement 25 feet in the water. And that is what happened to another nautical explorer by the name of Ford, Ensign Ford.
He decided. And in fact,
reminds me of Hawaii, just a lot colder.
I thought that.
this is the end of the line. I didn't know the sign.
Sun's in the wrong spot, right?
Yeah.
You get to the sun, so the contrast is really low.
Sorry.
No, no, that's okay.
Everybody will get a chance to see it, photograph it, look all around, and we unload our passengers so they continue into the ice and get as close to the face as they can. In their smaller vessel, we want to reload them. We want to meet everybody on the steward and gene. So once they're offloaded, we get them to do. You can see water splashing up at the face of the glacier. This, where it's gapped.
Okay, see if those, I can't see from my glasses. So
I sure it's a great thing to say. When you get in to the ice like this, depending on the size and shape of the barrel, if it's a little deep, or if you get a current that's super compressed, as you're at your rear point, you're going to get it. And one of the ways that we use to cheat when we paddle on the glacier bed and the way it is, we, it was a couple week trip and we figured out coming back out that if we just waited until the tide was going out, we could throw a line on one of these burners and just tow us out with the tide. Of course, they're wildly unstable. You might be able to pull the line off and just let it go. So we always just let it go. And if we had to, it goes retrieval. So here especially, you can see the signs of glacial succession. And that is the process that takes place when vegetation begins to lodge, if you will. In the cracks, these horizontal striations left. the fields are always sitting through here. Where the vegetation is on the port side of the peter side, you can see that it's beginning just right on these little horizontal cuts. And what happens is just dust and dirt and glacial flour and whatever lodges in these little cracks. And lichens are one of the first things that grow, and you know, down there, algae's got. We get some mosses and fungi are seasonal relationship between the algae and the algae. So they begin to grow these little green plants that you see on the ground. And when they die off in the fall, their leaves add to their fluff. See, a spruce crown is carried in by the wind, or a willow seed on the wing of a bird, something just lodges in there and begins grasses, just tough stuff that can't survive this polished rock. And it's just a matter of years before the spruce are able to root. And then that's what forested sides, but it's hard to imagine when you look at this straight up polished rock.
At Glacier Bay, it's like that, but all the way around you.
Very soon, in a couple hundred years, it'll be covered with forest. By looking at the most unappealing place to stand on any mountain face, and that's where you'll see a mountain goat.
The nose of our ship is right up against that rock.
Isn't that crazy? That's why I'm filming it.
Oh, that's scary.
It's pretty creepy. And there's plenty of space, but... Oh, yeah. Just look over there. You can tell. There's lots of room. Seals must be right up next to the glacier, because I haven't seen a single one since we passed that one berg early when we were first coming into Endicott. So I'm informed that I saw last night
that the forward decks were closed because of wind. This evening, because we're in the inside passage, they will probably not be closed, and we will be able to access them to see if we have northern lights. I checked with the bridge and they said no, which surprised me because it was very clear when I was up, but I couldn't get forward to really get a view, so we'll just keep hoping that we might be able to see them tonight, or we might be able to see them tomorrow night when we're heading south, and then we can go on the aft, the stern of the vessel, and have a view north. John Muir had a really tough childhood. He was raised in this strict Calvinist household, and children overworked extremely hard. In Kent Haycox's book, The Ice Had Started a Fire, he writes about one time that the well ran dry, and John, as the oldest of these children, was sent down to dig it up. And he worked at it for days and days and days. And when he didn't come up, one day his younger brother went down to check on him, and he was passed out at the bottom of the well. They managed to get him out to revive him. They talk about how cold it was. Growing up in Wisconsin. He was born in Scotland. Day was over, light was fading, and it was now or never, so Muir got down on his knees and encouraged sticking from the other side. And the dog began to slowly, one step at a time, each notch Muir had cut, work his trembling body across this suspended bridge. Muir all the time saying, hush your fears, my boy, you're going to make it okay. So,
I look at the top of it with her white specs, and then you can see it. Except she's up
there.
What boat?
Yeah.
I don't know what she would wear.
White top she sees.
She's way up front looking at the
side.
There's snow
outside.
Really
high.
Well,
it's
a little
So you're ready to roll, and what you're looking at